Hey guys, welcome to today's video. We are going to be testing out new products at the drugstore, and you guys enjoyed last week's new at Ulta try-on haul so much that I thought I would sit down again with a bunch of brand new makeup and just talk to the camera and we will try everything out together. This is all brand new stuff that I have never put on my face. So this can go one way or another. We're going to, you know, talk about the good, the bad, and figure out what new products are awesome. I think with this video, I am going to do a final check-in at the end of the day. I was reading the comments as I always do, and you guys really wanted to see that last check-in to see what wore well and what didn't. So let's start out with this guy right here. This is from Physicians Formula. This is their Mineral Wear Cushion Corrector Primer Duo. I have two of them. I have noticed a lot of the packaging with Physicians Formula has the hollow loveliness going on. I am so into that right now. Nailogical, Simply Nailogical, I love her. She's the one that started the whole holosexual thing. That is one of the funniest videos ever. Anyway, I adore her channel and I cannot help every time I see anything hollow that I get very, very excited. Okay, so opening up this cushion primer color correcting duo, I see that it's not a brush that you get in here. It's actually kind of a weird sponge dual-sided little situation here. This is the weirdest brush ever. What is this? We're gonna go with it though. So I'm gonna open this guy up and we will do the big reveal together. Ooh, yes. Okay, so you have one side that is yellow and another that is green. Wow, that is actually really yellow and really green. They are not holding back. I don't know that I really want to put this on my face, but in the art of doing this video, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna wipe this off my fingertips though and use the applicator. Maybe that will work better. So I took the yellow side into the yellow portion of the cushion foundation, and I'm gonna use this actually kind of underneath my eye a little bit. Okay, that's pretty horrible. What on earth? I don't get this. This applicator is absolutely god awful. Just don't even use it. Oh, there, I got some green on me too. Well, this video is starting out kind of a little bit crazy. I kind of was thinking that I would like prime this triangular region and maybe it would help my pores right here and it would color correct a little bit before I went in with concealer. The yellow is said to correct dark circles and dullness, and the green corrects redness. I don't have a lot of red on my skin, so I don't really need that green side, but the yellow side, I don't know that it actually is doing much. I feel like it's making me look more sick than I actually am, which PS, if I seem a little bit congested and off and maybe not full energy, I am dealing with a cold right now, but I still wanted to film. I'm at that like weird kind of like where your body's like, we don't know which direction we're gonna go. Either we're going over here and you're gonna be in bed for a week, or you're gonna take your vitamins and drink a lot of fluids and you're gonna get healthy. So I'm in that like, in between crazy kind of cold feeling, and this is making me look more sick. Great. I don't think I'm feeling this immediately. I do have the peach and lavender. This does have an SPF of 20 in here. It says it's gonna blur fine lines and pores. Maybe let's try a little bit of the peach underneath the eyes. Why not? This is just not my cup of tea. I don't like the applicator. I don't like the texture on the primers. We're gonna actually try a different primer that I have been very curious to put on my face. I have not used this yet. I hauled this in a haul several weeks back and I don't know, I wanted to wait to try it on camera. This is from Milani. This is the Prime Light Face Primer. Now this is a strobing and pore minimizing primer, the best of both. Let's cross our fingers and see how this works out. It has kind of like a gold sheen to it. That is such a strange texture because I really feel like it does what it says it's gonna do. It has minimized my pores right here, but it's super glowy. I'm kind of into it. I'm really curious how my foundation is gonna go on top of this. We're almost there, but I wanted to try out one other concealing product. This is from L'Oreal. These are the new Infallible Concealers. I have the color correcting one, and I do have just the concealer palette itself, which does come in different colors. This is 220, and I'm gonna use both of these. I'm actually gonna take a little bit of this peachy guy, and I'm gonna try to color correct a little more up in here. I have noticed my dark circles are a little more intense recently. I don't really know what's going on. Why can't I open this? Really? Oh my goodness. So these are really tough to open. That's kind of a pain. Okay, success. Comes with a little sponge, but I'm not gonna use that because I just, what is this? So the situation underneath my eyes, I just have a little bit of a purple discoloration. It doesn't matter how much sleep I get, whatever. It's just there. It's just something I'm dealing with right now. And I'm gonna take a little bit of this peach guy right here and hope for the best. That's actually quite nice, and I think that's working better than the Physician's Formula Primer, but that one was supposed to be just a primer. This one is an actual concealer. Now that I'm thinking about it, I don't really understand how a primer color corrector, like, I don't know that you'd want to put that all over your face, so I don't know. I like this way better as far as color correction goes. I actually really like that. That looks really nice. And then with foundation on top, it's going to kind of bring the color back to more of a normal place instead of being such a drastic change. I'm gonna take this concealer palette and I'm going to spot conceal on my face a little here, underneath my foundation and just see what happens. Whoa, that is some coverage. Oh, whoops. That is really nice. So this is under 15 bucks. I wanna say it's either $13.99 or $14.99. This is really nice. I'm gonna put on one of my favorite foundations, the Fiona Stiles Matte Foundation that I have been ridiculously stuck on for the past couple of months. And I'm going to use a new tool. This is kind of a Beauty Blender-esque with a slant right here type of a beauty sponge. I have dampened it. This is from Eco Tools. And I am just going to try something new, see how this applies my foundation. I bought this at Bed Bath & Beyond. I just thought it looked really cool. I like how it's like got a harsh kind of edge on the top there. Really good for getting up underneath the eye. Dude, you can get around your nose really, really nice with this. It reminds me of like a hybrid between the Cake and Bake sponge and a beauty blender. I'm really liking this. I like that. It really applied my foundation so nice. Okay, let's do a little bit of eye priming before we set things with powder. This is the Eye Primer Duo from Physician's Formula, and this has two primers. You get a matte one and a shimmer eye primer. I'm gonna go with the matte one. It's pretty cool. You get a nice doe foot applicator on here, and I think this is gonna work out nicely. I love eye primers. I do feel like they help your eyeshadow wear better. So I'm just gonna go ahead and place this on the lid and then blend it out with the same sponge. How about that? I love that this has an applicator on it. It makes it very easy to just kind of coat the eye and pat, 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 pat. You know what? I am really feeling like I just want a tiny bit more concealer, so I'm gonna take something new from Wet n Wild. This is a newer concealer. This is the Conceal Corrector, and they have a ton of different shades. I've been hearing really good things about the foundation. I probably should have tried that out today. I do wanna try it out. I might do like a first impressions. Let me know if you wanna see that because it's super affordable and I keep hearing everyone rave about it. I'm gonna take the shade Light Ivory and just do a little additional concealing underneath my eyes because I'm having a more is more moment and I feel sick. And whenever I'm sick, I feel like I just want extra concealer. Whoa. Hello, coverage. Do you guys see that? I'm like pulling it over here and it's still like it's kind of thick, but in a good way. Huh. And that may be a little bit too light for me, but we're just gonna go with it. This is what happens when you try out new products. Sometimes you don't get everything right. For those of you out there looking for a light concealer, maybe this helps you see an option. This sponge is so good. I can't even get over it. Okay, I am going to set everything with my CoverGirl powders that I'm still obsessed with. I use the Advanced Radiance underneath the eyes and the Outlast All Day on the rest of my face. I'll do that and then we'll try more new products. I'm gonna try taking this bronzer. Actually, it's not a bronzer. I'm calling it a bronzer. This is the shade Cocoa and I'm gonna use this as bronzer. Whoa, that has a lot of kickback. Do we see that? Whoo! I'm gonna load up my brush. And I'm gonna bronze the perimeter of my face. This is blending really nice. Ignore the hairdo. Oh my God, my hair today. I just was having one of those mornings where I'm like, nope, I'm not into it. I don't feel like doing that. I'll play with makeup because I always love doing anything makeup related, but the hair, forget it. I tried to use a dry shampoo. Like I was like, oh, I'm testing new drugstore products. Let's try a new dry shampoo too. I have it in front of me because I wanted to share with you guys. This sprayed on the hand doesn't show a lot of white, kind of white cast, but once you put it in your hair, if you're brunette, it's really powdery and white. So I wanted to warn you all that I'm not a fan of that one. I still love my Pantene. That one is completely clear, and it's my favorite from the drugstore as far as dry shampoos go, and I'm out of it right now, which really sucks, because I could use a little oil reduction in my messy hairdo today, but we're just gonna ignore that. I really love that bronzer. That just made my skin look so nice, and it actually blended out beautifully. Also, I'm gonna say, I didn't mention, but I feel like my foundation went on really nicely. The Milani Prime Light is really nice. Let's move on to a little brows. I'm kind of terrified to use these, but I just wanna see exactly what the texture is like. This is new from L'Oreal. This is the Brow Stylist. This is a kabuki blender on one end and a brow crayon on the other. I'm gonna use the shade Brunette first and kind of see how that looks. Yeah, that looks about right for me. You get a little bit of a, ooh, that's a huge brush on the end. Why do you need a huge brush? I don't really understand. I'm kind of thinking this might be more for people that have better brows than I do, that are fuller, because mine are just, I mean, they need a lot of help. Let's be honest, I don't have many brow hairs. I kind of already feel like this might be a hot mess. Actually, that's not bad. It's not my favorite because it's so wide that I'm having a hard time being really precise. And you guys know I prefer a really fine tip when I am doing my brows. Okay, I can see how some people would enjoy this. This is just not for me. So I'm gonna say it's a pass, and I'm gonna use my Fiona Stiles more finely tipped brow pencil to finish these brows off, and I'll be right back. All right, that's improvement, and we are moving on to blush now. I have this guy from Physicians Formula. You guys know I love the Butter Bronzer, and this is the Butter Blush in Plum Rose. The scent is so strong, you can actually smell it through the plastic without it even being opened up. That smells like vacation. It's pretty subtle. I'm not seeing a ton of blush color on my cheeks. Smells really good. It's blending pretty nicely, but you really kind of gotta layer it up a little bit. I'm wanting a little more of a pop of color, so I'm gonna take this pinky shade right here and just apply that directly to the apples of my cheeks. This is the Infallible Paints blush, and this is number 230. You get the world's most ridiculous blush brush in here. I don't even know what you're supposed to do with this. That is so bizarre. All right, we're gonna skip that, and I'm just gonna go right in here. That's pretty intense. Holy smokes. Oh my gosh, my under eye area is so light. It is kind of driving me insane. Dang it. I'm actually gonna take a powder that's a little bit darker and try to adjust the situation underneath my eyes, because it's driving me insane. I look slightly more normal now. All right, moving on. I really wanted to test out this right here. This is the Bronze Booster Shimmer and Strobing Highlight and Contour Palette. Now, I love the Bronze Booster by itself. I think it's a great bronzer. It has a little bit of a shimmer in it, and it just looks really nice on the skin. So I'm curious to see how these work out. I feel like the darker bronzer in here is gonna be really kind of intense. I don't know that that would look good on my skin tone. So you open this up and you actually have a full brush on the bottom. That's really cool. Maybe I can use it for highlight. So these are all super pigmented. Whoa, they're a little bit chalky. I'm gonna go in the medium shade in the middle, this kind of golden one, and just dab a little on the brush. I don't like this brush, no thank you. All right, different brush, going in again. Boom, look at that difference, okay? That is really gorgeous. What I just tried to do with the other brush just did not work out. This is a very in-your-face highlighter, so if you're looking for something subtle, this is not gonna be it. That is really very strong, but I think it's really pretty. Moving on to eyes, I have these new Infallible Paint Duos, and they have so many beautiful colors. This is a little bit intimidating because they're very opaque, and I'm not quite sure how they're gonna sit on the eye. Do we see this? I guess you can kind of sheer it out, but it's really intense. So I think the way that I'm gonna do it is by going off the back of my hand. This is the Infallible Paints in Sunset Fire. Does it go with what I'm doing? That actually is really pretty. Now I'm gonna take a brush so that I can be more detailed on the inner and outer portion of my lid. Dude, that dries down fast though. Like, you gotta work quick. Oh my God. I'm gonna apply it directly on the other lid because this dries down so fast. Maybe that's the better way to do it. It is very bright, clearly. It's a little bit chunky, which I do have to say I don't like, but you do have to be careful blending this. I kind of like it. I'm gonna go in with some powder shadow as well. I do have this from Physicians Formula. This is the multi-finish eyeshadow and I have the shade Natural Nude. I'm gonna take this shade right here and go in the crease to kind of soften the edges of this harsher shade that I have going on in the lid. I'm gonna take a smaller brush. This is from Gorgeous. This is the 018 and I'm gonna take the darkest shade in the palette and just kind of go on the outer edge of the crease. Those colors blended really, really beautifully. So I think this is actually quite nice. I really like Physicians Formula eyeshadows. I think they do a good job. They usually have these palettes where you get a lot of different color choices to choose from. Really nice compact, so I'm enjoying that. I'm gonna go back to the L'Oreal Infallible Paints and I'm gonna take the shimmery side now and just kind of dab it on the center of the lid. And that is moving the product around quite a bit, actually. I don't like that. The idea of these is really nice. I think you have to work fast while they're both still wet if you want to use two colors. Otherwise, it's kind of like when you paint your nails and you go in for a second coat too soon and you kind of move the color around. That is what unfortunately is happening. So to conceal that, I'm gonna add another layer. I'm gonna take this kind of shimmery shade in here and pat that directly in the center on top of the kind of balding areas from the cream shadow. And that kind of worked, but all in all right now, the paint, I don't think I'm into, even though I'm actually looking at this color and I'm like, wow, that's really beautiful all over the lid. I like this color. The formula was really chunky. All right, we're gonna move on to lips and then I'm gonna finish up with a little mascara and whatnot. I have two things to try out here. I have the Color Sensational Shaping Lip Liner, and this is in the shade Rich Chocolate. I have tried other shades out already and I really love this lip liner. The packaging is the most pain in the world to get into, so that's the thing that kind of drives me nuts about this. Ugh, work. All right, we're in. Success. You have a sharpener in the back built in if you need it, but this is an automatic pencil. It's really creamy, but not overly waxy, and I really like it. It's noisy outside. I apologize. I really do. Now we're going in with this new CoverGirl Outlast All Day lip product. You have a gloss on one side, you have more of a liquid lipstick situation on the other side. I am taking the shade Rich Caramel and hoping that it looks good on me. Oh man, I wish they had more kind of color that would go with this eye look, like a more brown, warm color. The colors that I have here, I have like a red one, I have more purpley toned ones, and then a nude. Maybe I should have done the nude. It feels very, very sticky. I'm gonna wait until it dries down to put the gloss on. It feels very sticky. So while the lipstick was setting, I decided to put on a boatload of mascara and I think I'm gonna skip lashes yet again. It's becoming this really crazy thing with me. But I do wanna say this lipstick, holy smokes, you guys, it's so sticky. Look, what the hell, right? It's really, really sticky. I'm gonna put the gloss on and hope that that makes it feel a little bit better. But right now, I hate the way it feels. Oh, it feels like so tight and dry and sticky. And it's already has like cracks in it. Ew, why? It looks nice from far away, I think. I have a feeling. It feels really weird. And then up close, you can see that this is really exaggerating any lines that I have in my lips. So I'm kind of feeling like this is probably not an item that I will reach for again, but I wanted to try it out. And I also will check back in at the end of the day and we'll see if there's anything remaining once the day is done. Because I feel like this is probably one of those super, super intense, long-wearing lip products that does wear for a really long time. But the price to pay is dry lips, cracked lips, and the fact that it just feels really, really strange. Like even when I'm talking, I'm like, oh my gosh, this feels so weird. So that's where we're at with the lip product. Everything else I think was pretty good. I like my makeup. I'm not complaining. I really actually enjoy this makeup look. I wish that the Infallible Duo, that cream duo, was not so chunky because this color is gorgeous. And the other colors that they have are beautiful, but I'm just kind of feeling like that was hard to blend. And I don't know, I'm kind of torn about it, but we shall see how everything wears. And I'm gonna set my face now with the new Milani Make It Last setting spray. It says that this will give me 16 hours of wear time, and we're gonna see how that goes. It smells really good, and the actual sprayer on there is so nice. The messy hair is just like a whole thing right now. Happy Friday. So this is the finished look. I am gonna do a quick check-in at the end of the day because I want to see how long some of these products wore. I will see you guys in a little bit. We have reached the end of the day and I have adjusted a couple of little things with my makeup that I want to fill you in on before we go over everything. I did put a little bit of this highlighter on the inner corners of my eyes and I love it. I feel like this is a really intense product. It is very, very highlighty, whether you put this on your cheeks, inner corners of the eye. Like, I can see myself reaching for this as an eyeshadow. All three of these are really beautiful. They are thick. They are definitely a little bit chunky, but if you knock the excess off and you blend them the right way, they're gorgeous. Like, how beautiful. Really, really intense, and the way they sit on the skin is just like, it gives this nice shine. So I'm enjoying that product a ton. So my lips were feeling really, really dry and I was like, oh, it's looking kind of weird. Like, my liner is showing too much. I want something with a little bit of a color in it to kind of even things out. So I picked up this one right here. This is the shade Mighty Berry. And I went to go in my head, what I thought I was doing was putting the gloss all over to just kind of even things out. But I actually took more of the color base. So then things got really chunky and weird. And then I put gloss on top of that. So I feel like I just have so much on my lips right now. It feels horrible. I can't even talk right with this on my mouth. So I'm gonna say these for me are a pass. I don't like it. I prefer using a liquid lipstick that I really enjoy and then a little bit of a gloss on top. The formula on this is just very, very tacky and sticky and weird. So this one was a pass. Love this so much. Oh my gosh, EcoTools little sponges like this. I love them. This is amazing. One of the best discoveries, I think, was this bronzer. It is sitting on my skin beautifully and giving me such a beautiful bronze without being overly shimmery. I think the Milani Prime and Light, I'm gonna use this again tomorrow, the setting mist, is doing its job because everything is staying really, really nice and tight, and I haven't powdered, I haven't done anything, and we're about 6 hours after I applied the makeup. So this is doing a really good job holding tight. And the Infallible Concealer I think was really cool. The eyeshadow is staying put like crazy. So as hard as it was for those Infallible shadows to blend, and even though they are quite chunky and I gotta play around with them, not moving the product away from each color, like if you want to use more than one color, if I can figure that out, I think I will actually reach for these again, just because look how it stayed put. Like, nothing has creased, nothing has moved, everything is still really bright. So they are super long wearing, they're just tricky to apply, and I'm gonna try and figure it out. So I don't have too many passes. I mean, the Physician's Formula, these kind of primers that are color correcting are kind of meh, I don't really like it, I don't really get it. The Butter Blush is not as intense as I would want it to be, but it sure does smell good and it blends really beautifully. So I hope doing this just gives you an idea of how things apply and what you might experience yourself using them for the first time. But all in all, I do like my makeup look today and it has worn really beautifully. So we're gonna wrap things up here, but thank you so much for hanging out with me. I love you guys so much. I will also have a hot product of the week linked below. I was on Style Code Live last night. If you missed it, go and check out that link and watch the episode for more great product recommendations. Also, if you guys enjoy this top, because I have been loving this, every time I look in the mirror, I'm like, this is super cute. It's very, very affordable. It's from Laura's Boutique. I will have that listed below. I almost never talk about products that I like as far as fashion, but let me know if you want to hear more of that. And know that it won't be an affiliate link at all, just so you know. But Laura herself from Laura's Boutique was in my home watching the Super Bowl on Sunday, and she did give this to me, and I love it. Anyway, that's about everything I have to share with you guys. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. I love you so much, and I will see you all in my next video. Mwah.